Good afternoon. I'm Cameron Clark, and I'm the director of the Indiana Department of Natural Resources. With me is the Indiana State Forester, Jack Siefert, who runs our Division of Forestry. And Jack, one of the things I think people want to know is, how do they know that our state forest system is being managed in a sustainable way?
About 2005 and 6, we put a strategic plan together, Cam, that looked at the best sciences and our ability to maintain long-term sustainability. And one of those things we looked at real early on was we needed a third-party auditors. We needed somebody who could give the public the perception as well as the confidence that we were managing sustainably. So we went about this process of hiring outside auditors to look over our shoulders, so to speak.
Who are these auditors?
There's two firms.
The Forest Stewardship Council.
They're out of Bonn, Germany, and that's considered sort of the gold standard for environmental standards. And the other one is the Sustainable Forestry Initiative, which is the North American standard. And that was originally developed by the industry in the South and has sort of evolved to be a broader-based system that looks at environmental issues as well.
And how does Indiana implement these sustainable practices?
What we do is every year the auditors come in and they audit us against our records, our processes, the standards that these various certification bodies have. And for the public, there's about, depending on the program, there's anywhere from 10 to 12 principles. And within those principles, there's can be up to 200 indicators that you have to meet. So every 5 years, we go through this entire 200 principles and indicators every year. They look at every forest across our system. They'll monitor 20% on a five-year cycle.
Tell us about your staff, those people who are managing these forests, to those principles.
Our foresters are really more than just foresters. They're wildlife biologists, they're archaeologists, they're ecologists, they're water quality specialists. So we have a pretty good cadre of folks with a broad discipline, and we all get together and look at strategic planning processes. And when it comes to the auditing process, we have internal protocols that we have to do to maintain the integrity of each of those specialties.
How many years of experience do you have on your staff?
Across the spectrum, depending on retirements, we're probably pushing 400 years of experience across our system on our state forest side.
So how has your program scored over the 10 years you've been going through the auditing process?
We've done fairly well. I mean, the first year you go through any scoring like that, you're always going to get what they call major or minor corrective action. So that was the first couple years we had to do some things. We put in some protocols. We did some monitoring. We put in inventory systems that we didn't have in the past. But after we got past the first couple years, we've been pretty successful. And actually, the last 2 years of a 10-year cycle that we've been in, we've done very well. We've had no corrective actions, and actually the auditors rate us very well.
How does that program fit within the backcountry area and the harvest that is upcoming?
Depending on the principles and the criteria, there's some expectations that you have a diverse forest. So that means a diversity of age classes, it means a diversity of species as well. And this backcountry area, as well as our nature preserves, are what we call our older forest conditions. And that is part of one of those principles, that we have a diversity of habitat types, not only for the trees, but for the flora and the rest of the fauna that's in the forest.
And these auditors, have they been satisfied with how we've been managing the backcountry area?
Absolutely. They've been very happy with it. Again, there's opportunities for people to contact those auditors if they have an issue with whether we're meeting those goals or not. And those auditors will come back to us and ask us for documentation, for proof. Performance, and we provide that, and they've been very happy with our processes.
And the auditors at the end generate a report that
Yes. Is
available for anybody who wants to read it.
Yes, every year, generally December, January after the audit in October, November, they'll send a draft, and they usually give us two options. One is a short version, and another one's a long version, and long versions are generally over 100 pages. We've taken the approach, we're going to let the public know everything. So all of that information, that 100-page document, is posted on our website. Anybody can view that.
Great. Well, thank you, Jack.
You're welcome.
I appreciate your time.
Thank you.